Today we are here to tell you about why you should invest in our nuclear power plants. So what is nuclear power? So nuclear power originates from the splitting of uranium atoms, a process called fission. So the point of nuclear power is to generate heat and to produce steam, which we'll put into a turbine generator and generate electricity. So one good thing about nuclear power is that it does not burn fuel and it doesn't create greenhouse gas emissions. So a nuclear reactor is a machine that can convert the nuclear energy into shaft horsepower, neighborhood heating, or a lot of other things that we use for civilization. So the relationship between voltage and current in an ideal conductor, this relationship states that the potential difference, which is voltage, across an ideal conductor is proportional to the current running through it. Potential energy is stored inside of the energy, gravitational energy. There will be extra friction, and this will do work that is irreversibly lost. For example, a golf ball rolling down a grassy slope, resistance by the grassy surface will cause some of the potential energy to be lost.
So, how nuclear power plants produce their electricity? So, it starts out with fission. Fission is the splitting of an atom into two smaller atoms. The smaller two atoms do not need as much energy to hold them together as the bigger atom does. So the surplus of the energy is released as heat and radiation. In a series circuit, the current through each component is the same, and the voltage across the circuit is the sum of the voltages across each component. In a parallel circuit, the voltage across each component is the same, and the total current is the sum of the currents through each component. Furthermore of how it is produced. So nuclear power plants use heat released from fission to make electricity. The power plants split uranium atoms into two smaller atoms, and then the extra energy is released and used as heat. Uranium is a mineral rock that is non-renewable, and there's abundance of this rock, and it is a cheap source. The heat made by fission is used inside a nuclear reactor and then used to create water into steam. The steam is used to turn turbines, and those turbines drive generators that create electricity. The steam then is changed back into water and is cooled in the cooling tower. Then the water can be used over and over again.
Probably asking yourself how the electricity gets to the city. Well, the electricity that power plants generate is delivered to customers over transmission and distribution power lines. Transformers at substations increase or reduce voltages to adjust to distribution lines that carry the electricity to homes and businesses. An electric current is a flow of electric charge. This can either be AC or DC current. The rate per unit time at which electrical energy is transferred by an electric current circuit, AC currents can be mobile, DC currents have to be plugged into a power source. What type of electricity is made? The fission creates heat that heats up the water to make steam. The steam spins a turbine that creates electricity. The electricity goes through transformers to produce correct voltages and electricity. Nuclear power plants work in a similar way to simple cycle core or oil plants, but instead of burning fuel, they smash atoms apart to release heat energy. This is used to boil water, generate steam, and power a steam turbine and generator. Alternating currents, or AC currents, is produced in all kinds of power plants, except solar, throughout the world. Alternating current means that the direction of current flowing in a circuit is constantly being reversed back and forth.
So you're probably wondering how it actually generates the heat. Well, so first they split the uranium atoms to generate the heat. They use the heat to turn the water hot and put it into steam, which powers the turbine to make the electricity. The electrical resistance of an electrical conductor is a measure of the difficulty to pass an electric current through the conductor. This is an example of a nuclear power plant. So the RE Jinnah Nuclear Power Plant in New York is the smallest nuclear power plant in the United States, and it has one reactor with the electricity generating capacity of 582 megawatts. Energy storage is the capture of the energy produced at one time that is used for later use. Energy transfer is the conversion of one form of energy into another, or the movement of energy from one place to another. When an object acts on another object, it is using its external force to do work on it.
So how cost effective is a nuclear power plant? It only costs about $9 billion to build. And the fuel is uranium, which is a cheap source of fuel that we have enough to last for the next 80 years. And a nuclear power plant only uses 27 metric tons of uranium per year, and one metric ton equals about 1,000 kilograms. The cost of a cycle of 1 kilogram of uranium is about $1,390. So in total, it only costs a little over $37 million per year to run a nuclear power plant. So what are some impacts of a power plant? You have to build it in a large area near a natural body of water, and some social impacts would be you have to convince people that are living near it that it is safe and that it's built with secure safety measures.
So here we are going to be talking about why our nuclear power plant is the best for this town. So wind and solar power have their place in society, but because they are unpredictable, they can't really replace big load plants like coal, nuclear, and hydroelectric. Natural gas is already too expensive, and its price is too evaporative to risk building big baseload plants. Hydroelectric resources are built pretty much to their capacity, so nuclear is the only practical solution. Nuclear energy is the largest clean energy source in the United States of America, producing more carbon-free electricity than all other sources combined. 2017 shows that nuclear energy generates nearly 60% of America's emission-free electricity, which is nearly three times the amount generated by hydropower, more than 3.5 times the amount generated by wind, and more than 18.5 times the amount generated by solar. America's nuclear power plants prevent 700 million metric tons of carbon dioxide from entering the atmosphere each year. That's the equivalent of the exhaust from 100 million cars.
These are some more reasons why nuclear power is the best source of electricity. So once again, they're very cheap to run and emit little to no greenhouse gases. The generators can run and produce electricity no matter the weather or if they have power shortages. The generators can last 40 to 60 years. Once again, they don't produce any dangerous gas emissions. They run on uranium, so they don't have to burn fossil fuels. Compared to other low-emission energy sources like wind and solar, the nuclear energy has a much higher efficiency. The power plants take up less space than the traditional ones while providing the same power capacity. The energy used in a power plant can be safely transported to anywhere you would like. Nuclear energy may just be the energy source that can save our planet from catastrophic climate change. Nuclear energy is the only large-scale, cost-effective energy source that can reduce emissions of CO2 while continuing to satisfy and growing demand of power. I hope you enjoyed our presentation over the nuclear power plant. I hope we discussed many details over why you should believe that the nuclear power plant is the best.